Following example deals with finding the derivative of exponential functions. First thing we notice when we see this question is the constant is the base and the function is the exponent. So we're not using the power rule. We're going to have to use the rule for derivative of exponential functions. So in this case, the first rule here, since the base is not e, it's another constant. And it tells us the derivative is the same function repeated multiplied by the natural log of the base, and then multiplied by the derivative of the exponent. So the answer for this then, the derivative is the same function repeated multiplied by the natural log of the base, and then the chain rule says times the derivative of the exponent, which in this case is 4. And other than writing these in a different order, there's nothing else to do to simplify there. So that's it. That's the answer. The next example, again, base is a constant, exponent is a function, so we have to use this rule. We also have its multiplication with another function, so we also have used the product rule here. So the derivative then, 2t, derivative of the first, keep the second, 2 to the t, plus keep the first, multiplied by the derivative of the second, so the derivative of 2 to the power of t is 2 to the power of t, times the natural log of the base, multiplied by the derivative of the exponent, which here is 1, but we'll show it just for completeness. Final answer simplified then, best we can do is factor out anything that's common. So in this case, we're going to have t times 2 to the t outside of 2 plus t ln 2. And that's our final simplified answer. In our next example then, we have the natural log of the cosine of e to the 2x. Base is a constant, exponent is a function. We're going to use this rule here. So then the derivative from the outside in, so first the natural log, 1 over everything else stays the same, multiplied by the derivative of what was inside. So the derivative of cosine, negative sine, and the part in brackets stays the same, multiplied by the derivative of what was in the brackets. So the derivative of e to the 2x is e to the 2x, multiplied by the derivative of the exponent, which is 2. So lots of chain rule there, but just one part changes at a time. First the ln, then the cosine, then the e to the x, then the exponent. Simplifying, we have a negative. Sine over cosine, since the arguments are the same, is tan of e to the 2x. And I guess we could stick the rest out front, so 2e the 2x, put the constants in front. And that's our final answer, negative 2 e to the 2x tan of e to the 2x.